Hello everyone and welcome to a split review. And in this video I'm going to review Human Free Eden by Like Weeds and Bastard Noise. This is a new split cassette released by the label Orb Tapes from Like Weeds and Bastard Noise. This for me is a pretty intriguing release, and after listening to the announcement of this thing, it immediately became one of my most anticipated releases out of this year. Like Weeds is an artist that I've discovered recently, and I've actually been amazed with everything that I've heard out of him so far. This project keeps on creating great after great releases. I've actually been astonished by the consistency of the catalog so far, as in my opinion, Like Weeds provides some of the most well-produced and some of the most engaging noise releases I've heard in recent memory, and it has actually managed to be one of the most intriguing projects when it comes to harsh noise, constantly looking forward to how it's going to experiment with each new release. On the other hand, Bastard Noise is a more well-known project that has been going around for a while. There is a massive catalog under their belt going for lots of years, and in some of those occasions they're not even known for going into harsh noise releases rather than directions of noise rock and extreme experimental metal music. So this leads to a catalog that ends up being far more inconsistent. However, from what I've heard so far out of Bastard Noise, I've been intrigued by some of the releases they've pulled out. But even with that being said, I was more excited getting into the Like Weeds side, which listening to it follows a similar pattern with some of the previous releases, with what feels like it's insanely noisy, monotone bass drops that are being put into pretty simple loops and structures that are actually pretty easy to follow. And that's what I find really intriguing about Like Weeds, is that even if some of the text end up being really harsh and ear-piercing, this structure ends up making it really easy to follow and digest, without becoming way too semi or monotone, and on the other hand, it's not all over the place. There is a really intriguing constant progression with all of the tracks, but it never leaves out the main elements of the structure, which for me makes for some pretty fascinating results. And I think that this side over here is not an exception. Even if in some occasions we get some pretty similar stuff with the material provided over here, I'm still pretty impressed with how this side ended up being put together. Once again, I managed to see progression over here, and like I said, the production on many of those tracks is amazing, but I think that in this occasion, Like Weeds outdid themselves once again, providing what is, in my opinion, some of the best sounding noise tracks out of every Like Weeds release. The production on this one is astonishing. It sounds incredible. The constantly evolving noise textures out of the first track Othered simply blow my mind. The extremely harsh, ear-piercing portions would constantly go into higher frequencies, but it never gets obnoxious. It constantly manages to have the perfect balance. A really astonishing use of noise feedback, this track just simply sounds so good. And it's so simplistic in its structure, it's easy to follow, and it's just done in a magnificent way. Also, the background ambience and the silent portions of the loops really adds nicely to the experience, not just in this track, but the whole Like Weeds side in general. As it's always those two worlds colliding together, combining nice and haunting dark atmospheres with extremely brutal and relentless noise portions. The second track, Dislocation, ends up going into some similar noise patterns. This track is 11 minutes long and it's separated by two different sides with two different sets of loops and an intermission towards the middle in order to get you prepared from the one side to the next rather than just immediately colliding together, and I can't really decide which one of the two sides sounds the best, but both of them ended up having some similarities with some of the additional noise feedback, which in my opinion this was a really cool touch. And once again, the sound, the harsh portions are spectacular, there is this great balance, and I like how the tracks constantly evolve, using more sounds, becoming more and more intense, and being refreshing all the time. Also, when it comes to the last minutes, I like how the loop evolves, going to a slower tempo and stretching all of the noise portions, making them sound more intense and just creating a really nice conclusion to the whole experience. Now the third track, Fenland, ends up focusing more on the atmosphere rather than containing harsh noise portions. This one goes more into some junk metal abuse noise stuff, which is something that we've seen out of the sound of Like Weeds, and in my opinion it's done in a really nice way here. It's 5 minutes but it passes so quickly without even realizing it. Also, the fact that some of the junk metal portions end up being looped is a really nice touch. It ends with what feels like unsettling siren sounds, and then it transitions into the final portion out of the Like Weeds side with a track Black Vandal. This ends up being more of like a combination of the two sides of this particular project, combining the harsh noise elements with chunk metal abuse noise. And this, in my opinion, doesn't really contain some of its strongest elements. I think that it would benefit if it was done like the track Dislocation, which would contain two separate portions, as in this one it ends up feeling like dragging a little bit. And towards the second half, we end up having more of like a dark ambient portion with some spoken word dialogue samples being put together, and a nice touch towards the end with a siren sound being put once again, as like with the ending of the previous song. So after being astonished by the like which side, I was kinda worried in which directions the Bastard Noise side would go, because I didn't want this to be a drop in quality, especially considering that the Bastard Noise side is only one huge 32 minute track. But upon listening to the Bastard Noise side, I really like the results. I wouldn't really say that it's on the same quality as the Like Witch side, but I still ended up being really pleased with what Bastard Noise provided in this massive 32 minute track. So in this occasion, we're talking about a harsh noise track that goes into many different portions. This one goes more into free improvised directions, it's a bit all over the place, and it can be chaotic at times. And I really liked some of its aspects. It has a bit of a more raw sounded aesthetic, but it still works really nicely. There are portions over here that sound really intense and chaotic, and then there are other portions that feel sort of like intermissions, where you have some background ambience and mostly just some really simple monotone noise portions, which when it comes to those particular moments, I wouldn't really say that this track was at its strongest. I think it reaches its peak with more intense moments, with my biggest highlight being towards the end. The final sort of like 10 minutes are incredible. There is this loop portion that sounds awesome, and every single other free improvised element with the noise textures is really cool. But especially this final intense noise portion is awesome. I like the loops, it's really infectious, it gets easily stuck in your head, and it definitely makes for some of the greatest moments out of this entire project. And we're talking about a really lengthy project, like it's more of like an hour of material, so it's not really easy to get into, especially if you're not that used to lengthy noise releases. So even if the Bastard Noise side has its inconsistencies, which is kinda understandable since we're talking about a massive track, it's easy to find spots that do not hit as hard in a 32 minute song. However, it still managed to have some amazing moments that managed to make the Bastard Noise side stand in its own and containing some really cool and memorable material for the entirety of this release. So I was excited for this split, and I ended up being really amazed by the final results. I am really impressed by the consistency of the Like Witch releases, and this one contains some of the most sonically incredible moments I've heard out of the entire catalog. And even when it comes to the Bastard Noise side, I think that this is some of the greatest stuff they've done in a really long time. So for me, this release ends up being an essential for harsh noise music, not just in 2022, but in general. I would go as far to say that this is one of the most essential harsh noise releases, period. In my opinion, there is something really astonishing about this particular release, making this one of my strongest recommendations, especially out of all the underground noise releases I've reviewed on my channel. This one is incredible, and I highly suggest you to go and check it out. I'm gonna give Human Free Eden an 8+ out of 10. What's your opinion on this split? Like it, dislike it, why, and what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.